Hello everyone. Today's video lesson is about a concept which is a favorite of question setters in various entrance exams. It's from the topic number system. We are going to discuss how to count the number of trailing or ending zeros in a factorial or product. And we are going to solve a lot of related questions to cover this topic comprehensively. So let's get started. First things first, what do we mean by the term trailing zeros? And for example, let us suppose someone asks you, what is the number of zeros in 12 factorial? By the way, if you Google 12 factorial, it throws up a value of 479,001,600. So what's your answer? 2 or 4? Well, clearly there are 4 zeros. Please understand that if we need to count the total number of zeros, then we will need to calculate its actual value. There is no escaping that routine. But if we need to count only the number of ending or so-called trailing zeros, the zeros at the end, they are 2 in this case, and we can find out the number of trailing zeros even without calculating the actual value of 12 factorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do that. So keep that in mind. The correct question is, what is the number of trailing zeros or ending zeros in 12 factorial? Okay, so taking the same example, we have the value of 12 factorial. This number has 2 zeros at the end. It can be written as 479,00,16 into 10 raised to the power of 2. That is to say, the highest power of 10 that divides this number is 2, which contributes to these two trailing or ending zeros, isn't it? Further, we know that 10 is equal to 2 into 5. 2 and 5 combine to make a 10. So, we can expect that the number of 10s in a product will be governed by the total number of 2s and 5s contained in it. It is a very, very important point to remember in order to understand this concept. Let's move on to our first question on this topic. This question will further help us understand the concept and build a proper method to solve such questions. Find the number of trailing zeros in 2 raised power of 8 into 5 raised power of 4 into 3 raised power of 2 into 7 into 13. In this question, a number is given to us in its prime factorization form. We have already seen that the number of trailing zeros is simply equal to the number of tens contained in the product. And each 10 is formed by combining a 2 and a 5. So, number of tens in a product are in turn governed by how many 2s and 5s we can combine into 10. So, this long expression, we don't need to calculate its value to solve this question. You'll be wasting a lot of your precious time if you do that, okay? Just try to see how many 2s and how many 5s are there in this product. 2 raised power 8. So how many 2s? 8. And 5 raised power of 4. So how many 5s? The answer is 4. We can combine only 4 2s with 4 5s and we will get 4 10s. So, highest power of 10 in this product is 4. And that is why the number of trailing zeros in this number, this product, is also 4. So, remember, the number of tens will be limited by the powers of 2 or 5, whichever is lesser. So, if the number can be written as 2 raised power of A into 5 raised power of B into other factors, then, number of trailing zeros is the smaller number out of A and B. Next, we need to find out the number of trailing zeros in 76 factorial. No matter which factorial is given to you, the procedure for finding the trailing zeros is the same in each case. So, pay attention. We already know that 76 factorial is nothing but the product of first 76 natural numbers. 1 into 2 into 3 into so on up till 76, right? So if we extract all 2s and all 5s from all these 76 numbers, it is easy to see that 2s are there in every even number. So there will be plenty of 2s. However, 5s come only from the multiples of 5. 5, 10, 15, 20 and so on. So the number of 5s will be our limiting factor. This is true for any factorial. Powers of 5 will be contributed by multiples of 5 and additionally by multiples of 25, multiples of 125 and so on. So to determine the total power of 5 contained in this number, count how many multiples of 5 which are less than or equal to the given factorial. 5, 10, 15, 20 up to 75. In other words, divide 76 by 5. The quotient is 15. So there are 15 multiples of 5, each of which will contribute at least a single 5 to this product. Additionally, don't forget that if there are multiples of 25 in this product, each of those will contribute an extra power of 5 because 25 is 5 raised to the power of 2. How many multiples of 25 which are less than or equal to the given factorial? Only 3 of them, 25, 50 and 75. Alternately, if we divide 76 by 25, the quotient is 3, which means 3 multiples of 25. We get 3 extra 5s. How many total 5s? That would be 18. And there would be as many 10s in 76 factorial. 18 10s. So the number of trailing zeros will be 18. Okay, so once we have understood the concept behind trailing zeros, let's devise a general method to find the number of ending zeros for any factorial, say n factorial. The number of trailing zeros in n factorial is equal to bracketed n divided by 5. This term gives us the count of multiples of 5 from 1 to n, each of which contribute a 5 to our product of n factorial. Additionally, all multiples of 25 contribute an extra 5 to the product. This term, bracketed n divided by 25, gives us the count of multiples of 25 from 1 to n. All multiples of 25 together contribute those many extra 5s to our product n factorial, over and above the ones we have counted here. Furthermore, all multiples of 125, 125 is 5 raised to the power 3, right? So they will contribute an extra 5 over and above the ones we have already counted here and here. Bracketed n by 125 gives us the number of multiples of 125 from 1 to n. And this expression will continue for further powers of 5, like 625 if need be. By the way, bracketed x is called the greatest integer function. And don't worry, if the greatest integer function looks too daunting to you, there's an alternate and much simpler way to find out the number of 5s in a factorial. Just divide n by 5 recursively till you arrive at a value that is less than 5 and add up all quotients like this. 76 divided by 5, the quotient is 15. We divide it further by 5, the quotient is 3, which is less than 5. So we stop here. That's it. Add up all quotients that will give you the number of 5s contained in n factorial. So 15 plus 3, that makes 18. There will be as many 10s as the number of 5s. So there will be 18 zeros in 76 factorial. So let's move on to the question on the title screen of this video. How many trailing zeros are there in 803 factorial? So very simply, 1 5 is contributed by each multiple of 5 less than 803. 160 of them. An additional 5 is contributed by each multiple of 25 less than 803, which are 32 in number. Furthermore, An additional 5 is contributed by each multiple of 125 less than 803, which are 6 in number. And since 803 is a huge number, we will need to see multiples of 625 less than 803. Obviously, only one of them, which is the number 625 itself. This number contributes an extra 5 over and above the ones we have already counted in these three categories. So total number of 5s and hence total number of 10s in this expression are 160 plus 32 plus 6 plus 1. That makes 199 zeros at the end of 803 factorial. We get the same answer by dividing 803 recursively by 5 as shown here. 160 plus 32 plus 6 plus 1 is equal to 199. There are 199 ending zeros in 803 factorial. Our next and final question is a very nice application of this concept. If you have understood it well, this question will not be very difficult for you to solve. The question is, find the number of trailing zeros in 1 raised power 1 into 2 raised power 2 into 3 raised power 3 into 4 raised power 4, so on up to 100 raised power of 100. Again, as in the case of factorials of numbers, the total accumulated power of 2 will far exceed the total power of 5 in this expression. That means the power of 5 will be the limiting factor. So to count how many tens will be there in this expression, we need to count how many 5s are there, okay? Now 5s come from all multiples of 5 along with their respective powers, which are these. All the bases are 5 into something. So for counting the number of 5s, we just add all the powers. That will be 5 plus 10 plus 15 up till 100. Using the formula for sum of an arithmetic progression, this will be equal to 20 into 5 plus 100 divided by 2, which is equal to 1050. But let us not forget that all multiples of 25 have an extra 5 in the bases because 25 is 5 square. These 4 are the multiples of 25. So the extra power of 5, or we can say the additional number of 5s contributed by them, is just add up the powers 25 plus 50 plus 75 plus 100, which is 250. So the total number of 5s in the product, which in turn will be equal to the number of trailing zeros at the end of the expression, is 1050 plus 250, that is 1300. That completes our topic. Hope you have understood it well and can tackle similar questions confidently from now on. Don't forget to subscribe our channel for more such useful content and do like and share our videos. Keep watching and take care everyone. Bye-bye.